Assalamu alaikum dear students. This is me, Arshad Bashir. In our last video, we talked about phonetics and phonology, types of phonetics, air stream. Then I told you that air stream is of two types, ingressive air stream, the air that we breathe in, and egressive air stream, the air that we breathe out. And I told you that most of the languages, human languages, are produced on egressive air stream. But there are some languages which are produced on egressive air stream. And those languages are called clicks, C-L-I-C-K-S. Dear students, today our topic is speech organs. In our body, there are some organs which are responsible for the production of speech. And without those organs, we won't be able to talk. But in those organs, there are some which are highly important. They have an active role to play in speech production. And some are less important, which have a passive role in speech production. And what are those organs? Let us see. Lungs. Chest muscles. Trachea. Larynx, pharynx, oral cavity, and the last one is nasal cavity. The organs which are responsible for speech production in humans are lungs, chest muscles, trachea, larynx, pharynx, oral cavity, and nasal cavity. Dear students, but these organs are categorized in three types. The first one is respiratory system. In respiratory system, we have lungs, chest muscles, that means diaphragm, and trachea. Number two, phonatory system. The first one is respiratory system, in which we have lungs, chest muscles, and trachea. Then we have phonatory system. In phonatory system, we have larynx. And the last one is articulatory system. And here we have pharynx, oral and nasal cavities. Oral cavity and nasal cavity. Okay. In respiratory system, we have lungs, chest muscles, trachea. And in phonatory system, we have larynx. Then in articulatory system, we have pharynx, oral cavity, and nasal cavity. Let's talk about respiratory system first. The role of lungs in speech production. Dear students, when we breathe in air, let me show it to you. Dear students, when we breathe in air, the air gets stored in our lungs. When we breathe in air, the air gets stored in our lungs. Okay, how the air gets stored in our lungs? Actually, the chest muscles, this diaphragm, the diaphragm is pulled down. The chest muscles are pulled down. And our lungs are enlarged. When the air that we breathe in, it gets stored in our lungs get filled with air, our lungs get enlarged. And after that, the chest muscles come to their original position, that means they relax. When the chest muscles relax, the air comes out of our lungs, the air is released from our lungs with force. Now, what is the function of lungs? Lungs store air. Lungs store air. Or we can say that lungs are responsible for providing air for speech production. Lungs provide air for speech production. After that, we have chest muscles. And I have just told you that chest muscles create pressure on our lungs. Create pressure on our lungs, and the air comes out of our lungs with force. From lungs with force. Okay. The role of lungs is that it stores air and it provides air for speech production. Then chest muscles, okay, they create pressure when they relax. When they come to their original position, they create pressure on our lungs and the air comes out of our lungs with force. Trachea. Then the air enters or moves into our trachea. The air with force enters our trachea, and trachea helps the air to reach the larynx. Okay. This is all about respiratory system. In respiratory system, we studied the role of lungs, then the chest muscles, and then trachea. Okay, lungs, then our chest muscles, and this trachea. Now, coming to phonatory system. What is phonatory system? Phonatory actually means, it comes from the word phonation. Phonation means adding of sound or creating sound. Phonation means when sound is created. Actually, we are going to talk about phonation, adding of sound and creating sound, but let me talk about the organs first. Okay. In phonatory system, we have larynx. Larynx, that we also call as Adam's apple. Okay. I'm going to make the figure of larynx. Actually, I'm not good at making figures. Let me try it. See, my dear students, this part is epiglottis. I'm sure that you might have read it. This part is epiglottis and this part. These are vocal folds, or we also call them vocal cords. This is epiglottis. These are vocal folds, or we call them vocal cords, because they have a cord-like structure. What are vocal cords? They are actually soft tissues. Tissues means they are actually soft. This is actually the soft fleshy structures. Vocal folds are actually flesh, very soft tissues of flesh. These are vocal folds, and this portion. This is glottis. Okay, let me repeat it. This is epiglottis. These are vocal folds here, and this part, this is glottis. Dear students, this glottis is actually a cartilage. Cartilage. And when the air passes with force through the glottis, vocal cords start vibrating. These vocal cords start vibrating when the air passes through the glottis, and with vibration sound is created. When vocal cords start vibrating, sound is created. You might have experienced it many times, that whenever your phone is on vibrating mode and your phone starts vibrating, that time sound is created. In the same manner, when air with force which comes or which is released from our lungs with force, when it reaches here, glottis, it starts vibrating these soft tissues, that means vocal folds. And in this way, Due to this vibration, sound is produced. Now, how is sound produced? For example, if I say B or P, this is actually sound. And how this sound is produced? It is produced when the air passes through our glottis with force, and due to that force, due to the pressure of that air, our vocal folds or vocal cords start vibrating. And due to that vibration, sound is produced. After that, but sometimes what happens? The air comes with less force. With such a force that the vocal cords do not vibrate. That the vocal cords do not vibrate, or the vocal cords vibrate less. If the vocal cords vibrate less, then such sounds are called voiceless sounds. We are going to talk about voiced and voiceless sounds once we finish this speech organs and other topics. Okay, I have told you that sometimes it so happens that when the air passes through the glottis, okay, the air has less force that time, okay, and the vocal cords vibrate, but their vibrating intensity is not so much. And due to less vibrating intensity, such the sounds which are produced, we call them voiceless sounds. And when the vibrating intensity is more, that time the sounds which are produced, we call them voiced sounds. For example, P sound. This is voiceless because there is less vibration. And this sound B, this is voiced sound. You can feel it if you place your fingers or palm here on the glottis. Here on the glottis. Now please say P. In P, there is less vibration. But if we say B, in B, there is more vibration. Okay. Those sounds where the vibration is more, we call it a voiced sound. And that sound where the vibration is less, we call it a voiceless sound. Okay, dear students, what have we studied in phonatory system? We have studied that in larynx we have glottis, which is actually a cartilage, and then we studied vocal folds, and I told you that vocal folds are soft tissues which are highly sensitive, that when air passes through them they start vibrating. If there is more vibration, then the sound which is produced is a voiced sound, and if there is less vibration, then the sound which is produced will be a voiceless sound. After that, the last one is articulatory system. What's articulatory system? Articulatory system is that part which helps us in the articulation of speech organs. For example, we have pharynx, oral cavity, and nasal cavity in it. What's pharynx? Dear students, if I open my mouth, you will find a part of flesh hanging there. And we call it uvula. This small part of flesh. Which is hanging, we call it uvula. My dear students, the part behind the uvula, up to epiglottis, that I showed you in larynx, the part behind uvula, up to epiglottis, we call it pharynx. Pharynx becomes a passage, it becomes a channel where from the air reaches our oral cavity. Now, coming to oral cavity. Dear students, oral cavity, that means our mouth, this portion, the portion between the lower jaw and the upper jaw, that's our oral cavity. Oral cavity is very is highly responsible, is very important in modifying in changing the course of air which comes from the lungs. And it is due to oral cavity that we are able to differentiate between sounds. For example, pa and ba. Okay. If we are able to create the differentiation, or if we are able to do the differentiation between the sounds, this is because of oral cavity. The modulation which occurs, which happens in our oral cavity. And then we have nasal cavity. Nasal cavity is actually our nostrils, which end at the back of our palate. Palate means roof of the mouth, in this portion. Okay, nasal cavity or nostrils, they end at the back part or at the root of our palate. Palate means roof of the mouth. And there are some sounds which are produced when air passes through the nasal cavity. For example, ma, na, or ng. For if I write king, king. Okay. This portion, ng, when we pronounce ma or na or ng in king, the air passes through our nasal cavity. And such sounds are called nasal sounds. Okay, my dear students, let me sum it up. I have told you that in speech organs, we have three types of systems. Respiratory system, in which there are lungs, chest muscles, and trachea. Then phonatory system, in which we have larynx, and in larynx we have two parts, glottis and vocal folds. Then we have articulatory system. In articulatory system, we have pharynx, oral cavity, and nasal cavity. And I told you that oral cavity is responsible for the modulation of sound. And that's why we can differentiate between two sounds. Now, in our next video, we will talk about oral cavity in detail, because this is the most important organ in speech production. We'll talk about the parts of oral cavity And after that, our topic will be the symbols, phonetic symbols. I think this is enough for today. Let me bid you adieu by saying Assalamu Alaikum.